What's wrong with his ears? Hey guys, Zach Morris here, and welcome back to Fallout 4. So I made an executive decision, decided to play this every day. Well, not every day, but every Monday, I guess. But I misspoke a little bit. Hold on, let me start again. Hey guys, Zach Morris here, and welcome back to Fallout 4. So I made an executive decision and decided to play this every Monday. So yeah, you guys can look forward to that. What you got here, little buddy?
Bingo.
Islander's Almanac. You collected an issue of Islander's Almanac. You unlocked POI map markers across the island. Huh. Point of interest, I would assume. I don't know how many of these there are, but...
Not enough folks value keeping the old CPU sharp.
Captain Avery said you can get me to Acadia.
Yep, that's what she said, all right.
You get your hands dirty? I'm done leading people to their deaths in the fog. Last fella couldn't keep up. Didn't last 5 minutes.
Okay, well...
Some parents are worried about their runaway daughter. She went to Acadia, and I need to find her.
Someone's headed for Acadia. There's always a story. Yours worth dying over, huh?
Just setting my timer here.
Yeah. I've done a whole lot more for a whole lot less.
Clever with words, are you? I can get you to Acadia. But you've got to listen to me. Go where I say, when I say it.
Mm-hmm.
Still won't be easy. You stock up on your necessities, Rad X and the like. Then the real work can begin.
Let's go, Longfellow.
Follow me.
I have a rat suit, so let's just throw this on. Yay, that he got a point there. But yeah, I got my rad suit. We should be fine. Maybe.
Get out of town. Acadia is above the fog line on the mountain. It's a bit of a hike. You might want to take this for a walk. Case foul and sin. Take it one day at a time.
Marlark jerky. Well, now I'm over encumbered. Thank you for that. There we go.
Old mountain trail for work. The fog ain't like nothing you see in the continent. And I think a dose of Radaway is all you need. Tracks. Fresh ones. Trappers ahead. When the bullets start flying, find cover. Keep your head down if you want to live. Keep your guard up.
Yeah, my rad suit should protect me.
Look sharp.
Gotcha. And why am I on the ground?
Thank you.
where are you? There you are. Ah! Took their head clean off. I'm going to need a different gun. Weapons. I have no ammunition for any other gun. Really? Oh, I have my... Where are you at, buddy?
Figured I'd have to take care of a lot of them. Might just make a proper Far Harborman out of you.
All right, if you say so.
Get you all turned around. There's something in your brain. Trappers were mean to begin with.
Yeah, I figured. It's the fog messing with their brain. Bye-bye. There we go. All right. Show me the way, Longfellow. Also, what is the islands based on in real world?
They usually stick to the deep fog. Best we steer clear. Started taking things for granted. Folk got short memories.
And then the fog rolled back and killed them all. Or turned them all into zombies, one way or another.
We ain't alone.
Got you!
Okay, so the Mirelurks and Gulpers seem to have a bit of a territory war here. And they stop being our friend.
Fresh.
Give me that Mirelurk meat. Is that edible? Alright, here we go. Back on the trail with old Longfellow.
Gulpers got a fondness for fresh water. A small gulper, like the ones in these parts, is a fair challenge. Now the big ones, they can grow 2-3 times the size of a man. Good thing you don't see too many of them.
Yeah, that is a good thing. All right, there we go. Come on, Longfellow, take me to Arcadia City, where the grass is green and the girls might be pretty. I don't know. I don't know the words.
Hold there.
Hello.
Stringing one more soul to their damnation, old man?
Well, what have we here?
It's the children of Adam.
Bad, worshiping lunatic. That's what.
Your barbs do not harm me. I am shielded by my faith.
How about okay. Bullets? Faith shield you against those too?
Let's just settle down, okay?
You're right. Waste of ammo.
Do not sully this one with your blasphemy, old man. You. I suggest you go no further. Arcadia is a nest of snakes. Beasts that subvert the will of Adam.
What's Arcadia done to make you distrust them?
They supply Far Harbor with the means to turn back Adam's holy fog. You'd do well to avoid such creatures, and instead seek the only true master of this land.
All right, I'm listening. Tell me about Adam.
Tell you? Look around. You stride through his kingdom. A land blanketed beneath sacred fog. A land Adam has claimed for his children.
Okay.
And you may join our family if he deems you worthy.
Worthy? What do I have to do to join?
There is a ritual his children must perform. If you succeed, you will be rewarded with entrance into our family.
Okay, sign me up.
Excellent. Head to the nucleus. There, Adam's plans for you will be revealed.
You're done wasting time with a fanatic. Let's move on.
Well, I just wanted to initiate a thing with him.
The air is clean. No fog. Acadia is not too far.
My legs are slightly damaged. What did I eat that gave me more power? And here we are, Acadia.
And we've arrived. Acadia's already been watching us for a good spell. If you want to talk with them, just go inside. They'll be waiting for you. You need my help again, you come see me. Got a cabin just outside of Far Harbor.
Yep.
A place to tool up your gear, get some rest, or get stinking drunk. Just make sure if you're bringing a bottle of something strong, there's enough to share.
Maybe later.
All right. But I'm serious about the offer. You ever want to hunt the forests and waters of the island together? I can think of worse things to do.
Okay. Yep, we completed a major quest for this. Best put my gun away. Well, not the weirdest ensemble I've ever assembled, but we unlocked a side quest. I guess I'll have to check that out in a bit, but not entirely sure what we did to unlock it. I don't know. I'll look into it later. Right now, let's just go in and talk to whoever.
You know, when I first climbed this mountain above the fog, thought to myself, now here is a metaphor worth taking in. You've entered a place of clarity, understanding, peace. While you're here in Acadia, Synthkind welcomes you as long as you welcome us.
I came here looking for Kasumi Nakano.
Really? I'm impressed. Few would brave the kind of journey you've had for the sake of someone else. Kasumi is here. She's safe and unharmed, and you're free to see her if you'd like. Before you do, though, tell me, do you think Kasumi is a synth?
We're not answering any more questions until you play straight with us. Just who the hell are you, really?
Good point.
There's only one synth with that kind of face and a mind of his own. I only see him when I look in a mirror.
Nick, it can't be you.
Don't give me that. What are you trying to pull? I've never seen you before in my life.
Please, if you're willing to give me a chance, I can explain.
Is this a joke? Do you really know Nick?
Let me tell you what I know, and you can judge for yourself. We were prototypes, Nick. The first synths capable of independent thinking and judgment.
Keep talking.
One of the Institute's experiments had to do with how our brains could process personality. If we could handle individualized feelings and behaviors, I was allowed to develop mine based on experience. But with you, they wanted to try transferring an entire personality into you. It took several attempts before the personality imprint worked. I saw you wake up not knowing who or what you were so many times. I couldn't let them do it to you anymore. We were the only two prototypes they made. I literally saw myself in you. You were my brother, Nick.
Huh.
I helped you escape the Institute. We left together.
If I were your brother, I'd remember.
That's where you'd be wrong. This happened over a century ago. There's only so much memory that can fit into the prototype brains we have.
I've heard enough.
I think you and I need to talk about this. Maybe not now, though.
Is it really possible that you wouldn't remember any of this?
You mean between the Institute failsafes, the beatings I've taken over the years, and plain old age? Or are you buying this whole, there's only so much room of their argument? I don't know. It's not like we've got the instruction manual.
Nick, is he really your brother?
If he is, it's news to me.
Hmm.
Since even be related? Just because we're from the same assembly line, does that make us family? I gotta think about this.
That's a good question, though.
We'll talk later. This is a lot to take in.
Nick, I don't need you to believe me. I'm just glad to see you again. Whenever you're ready, I'll be here. Now, about young Kasumi. It's important that you understand exactly why she's here. I asked you before if you think she's really a synth. If you could indulge me with an answer.
Why are you asking?
Because she came here with that very question. And the answer changes every part of her world. None of us take this transition lightly. She's facing the possibility of her entire life being a lie. That someone stripped her very identity from her.
Nobody did that.
Into something she isn't. I want you to understand that before you see her. She has a chance here to live as a synth, not hiding, not pretending to be something else. One more question, if you'll indulge me. You're here for Kasumi, but I suspect there could be another reason you came to us. Tell me, are you a synth?
I'm a human being, not a synth.
Are you sure? I don't mean to question you, but what's the first memory you have?
I was with my wife. We were getting ready for the day. I had to take care of my boy, Sean. A lot's happened since then.
But no memories before then? No childhood? Your first best friend?
He's been gone 200 years!
Kiss? That's usually a sign. Data is easy to migrate, but feelings, that's a hard thing to transfer into another mind. Isn't it funny how a memory can feel like a whole different reality? People, places, even sounds and colors can change. Or someone else has changed them. I won't lie to you. There will always be other explanations. Trauma, disease, the background radiation. They all take their toll on the mind. But I can promise you that you will be accepted here. Whatever you decide is true for yourself.
I'm not a synth. End of discussion.
I understand. I won't pry any further. Acadia is open to you. Feel free to walk the grounds. Introduce yourself to my co-founders, Faraday and Chase. Okay. Kasumi is usually working down below, whenever you wish to see her. Is there anything else you'd like to discuss before you go?
So, everyone here in Acadia is a synth?
Yes. Either they were escapees we managed to find before the Institute could, or they were victims of a mind wipe, and we revealed the truth to them. You're
right.
From the Commonwealth, like Kasumi, yes?
Yes.
I'm sure you've had your own experiences with my kind.
Well, I know Nick, obviously.
Yes. Of course. What else can I do for you?
I should...
I don't want to tell them that I'm in the Brotherhood or Institute. Perhaps that won't be fair. He'll get upset with me.
Are you feeling all right? I'm fine. You worry too much.
Sometimes I feel like you don't worry enough. You know we need three more relays this week. I'm coming in. You stay right there.
But yeah. Dima does pose an interesting question about whether or not the main player character actually is a synth. But there are a lot of things that contradict this a little bit. For example, there's a lot of factors that go into being a synth, including a recall code, and the fact that you were around before the war, before synths were being developed.
It's not them. Concerned about you, Dima. You can't solve all the world's problems. Certainly not all at once.
Dearest Faraday, relax. All will be fine.
So, you've talked to Dima. You know why we're here. I certainly hope that you'll consider helping us. Dima's vision is worth fighting for.
You're right. It is a good cause. Synths definitely deserve to be safe, just like everyone else.
It's so good to hear that.
What's wrong with his ears?
Please, make sure Dima knows that as well. He's put so much of himself into this. All his time and energy.
Seriously, what's wrong with his ears? Look at him.
Stops to think of himself. Sometimes I worry about... Well, if I wasn't here to make sure his equipment is all functional. And that's not even mentioning maintaining the fog condensers. So many things to keep track of.
Ooh.
You do all this work yourself?
Mostly, yes. I get help from the others when I can.
Seriously, what's wrong with his ears?
He understands Dima the way I do.
Can you tell me about the fog condensers?
Oh, those? Dima and I designed them when it became clear the fog was only getting worse. They're effective, but have such a limited range. Dima insisted we provide them to the people of Far Harbor, and I'm so glad we did. Without the condensers, I'm not sure they'd have anywhere left.
Dima looks like he's had a lot of work done.
Well, that's certainly an understatement. Between the two of us, we've made so many modifications. He was just a prototype, never built for all this. It took a lot to overcome the limitations of the original design and expand his memory. It really is remarkable, isn't it? He's overcome so much. He's become so much more than he once was. And all he thinks of is others.
If there's anything I can do to help out, just let me know.
Well, if you're determined to help, there is something you could do. It's likely somewhat dangerous, though, so I understand if you'd rather not. There's a boat along the coast of the island.
Fucking away.
Where we needed. Storage drives. The boat never finished the trip, you see. So the drives are still out there. I could really use them here for extra parts, if nothing else. My understanding is that the boat wrecked southwest of here. So, does this sound like something you could handle?
What happened to the boat? Why didn't it make it?
I'm not entirely sure, to be honest. Trappers, fog crawlers, there's no end to what's out there. And what might still be out there. But the point is that we already lost someone once. And I don't want to see that happen again. So, are you up for it?
Sure thing, Faraday. I'll get the drives for you.
Thank you. I really do appreciate it.
Yeah, this is a bit extensive, don't you think? Yeah, they built a lot of storage systems into this.
You got a pretty good track record cracking those little things. Take a swing at that terminal?
No, it's fine. Bottle cap? I saw bottle cap. I'm taking that. But yeah, Acadia's an old storage system.
New guy, right? Look, I'm not anybody worth talking to. My head is killing me. Now's not the time.
Sorry, didn't mean to bother you.
It's not your fault. You try having somebody botch a mind wipe on you and see how it feels. Then get back to me, okay?
What do you mean, mind wipe?
Oh, for fuck's sake. You're a synth on the run. You go to someone, you get a new face, and they wipe your mind so the Institute can't find you. Only somebody screwed mine up. So here I am. Now just, please... leave me alone.
All right, well, where's Chase?
You
oh, there you are.
Sumi here. I'm impressed. Perhaps not as quietly or efficiently as possible. But thankfully, she was never in any real danger. I'm afraid your journey was unnecessary.
I wanted to see for myself that she's safe.
You have my word. Acadia is a safe haven for synths. Were it not, I would not have aided anyone in reaching it. Every synth I've tracked down, every synth convinced to come here, has been assured that he or she will come to no harm. My job is to make sure they all remain safe, no matter what.
Happy and safe?
Stand?
Got it.
How do you manage to track down synths and bring them here?
I have a network of contacts throughout the area. Some from my time with the Institute, some after. I know the Institute's tactics. And use that to my advantage. You have Dima's blessing, so by all means, make yourself comfortable.
I'd like to help you all. Is there anything I can do?
Actually, as a matter of fact, there is. If you're serious about contributing, well, we've got a situation I need someone to look into. You've had some experience traveling around the island, so you may be decently equipped to handle it.
All right, I'm listening.
We were expecting a new synth to arrive, and he should have been here by now. There's been no sign of him. and I'm concerned that he might have become lost on the way here.
Oh, dear.
I'll find out what I can.
You should start by talking to Brooks in Far Harbor. He's one of us, a synth. He's the one who meets the new arrivals and gets them started on the journey here. Of course, he's not likely to tell you anything without proof that you're working for me. If he doesn't cooperate, tell him that his designation is L792. That should convince him. That's as much help as I can give you for now. Please, hurry. If that synth is out there alone, he won't last long.
Okay. Started the arrival. Talk to Brooks.
I assume you're not planning on staying long.
Acadia's far away enough from the Institute that we don't have to worry, right?
Yeah, you're probably fine.
Kasumi Nakano?
Sorry, I'm right in the middle of something.
What's that you're working on?
Just trying to cobble some pre-war junk into something usable.
Okay.
Now, do you mind telling me what you're doing here?
Your parents sent me. They want you to come home.
They did what? You came all this way for me.
You left without telling your folks why. You must have known they'd be worried.
Look, my mom and dad... I mean, those people that were taking care of me, they wouldn't want me back. Not if they knew the truth.
Kasumi, listen to me. You're not a synth.
Believe me, I've thought about that. How you can never really know. But it just answers so many questions. I thought if I just left, it would be easier for them.
But it wasn't.
How would that conversation have gone anyway? I've been lying to you this whole time. Your real daughter is dead and I replaced her?
You haven't replaced anyone. Kenji and Rei are still your parents.
Look, I get it. They hired you to bring their daughter back. And I wish I could. I really do. Acadia isn't what I thought it was. There's more going on than just the refuge. I can't leave until I've gotten to the bottom of it. I've been running for long enough.
If something's going on, then I can help. Just tell me what's happening.
I don't know how you could.
Hmm.
Wait. Wait, of course you can help. You find things, track down answers. That's what you do, right? That's why you came after me. What if I told you that there's a secret? A big secret. Here, on this island. Something way more important than just one lost girl.
What are you talking about?
Where to begin? You saw all those computers that Dima's hooked up to, right?
Yeah.
They hold his memories, or offload data from his brain. Or maybe some combination of both? Well, Faraday asked me to help do some repairs on them. And, you know, I got curious. There's like a century's worth of life experiences in there. And that's when I see it. Data models Dima has been making. One was the fog taking over Far Harbor. Another was a nuclear detonation on the island. Plus, death counts. What if Dima is so open and welcoming because he's actually hiding something from us? A plan to wipe out the rest of the island.
We should get to the bottom of this. If Dima is putting on an act, we need to know.
You don't trust Dima? After you came all this way for him?
I didn't come to Acadia for him. I came here because this place offered answers. And now that I've found a place I belong, I'd rather not lose it all if Dima is secretly planning to destroy everything.
All right.
I'll help if I can. But that's not much to go on.
I know. I've been working on that, but I haven't had much luck. I keep seeing Dima, Faraday, and Chase head into the laboratory at the other end of the hall.
All right.
Then they come out later looking like they've been arguing. There's actually a storage space right next to there. It'd be a perfect spot to hide and eavesdrop. But it's been locked up. I've also tried breaking into Faraday's terminal, since he and Dima are so close, but the security on it is crazy.
Eavesdropping on the next meeting sounds like our best bet.
Huh.
I'll see if I can find a way inside that room.
Okay.
But you're clicking.
Good luck. And come back as soon as you found anything.
From one case to a new one. It's never easy for us, is it?
Hold on. I'm going to, I'm gonna go check that clicking. Okay, I am back. I checked. I fiddled with my... No, that's still clicking. I don't know what's doing that. I don't know. Maybe it's something with the software. I don't know. I'll have to look into it. Yeah, that clicking's getting annoying. I don't think it's coming up on the recording. I don't know.
Feel free to say whatever is on your mind.
Kasumi says she's seen parts of your memories. Death projections. For Far Harbor and the center of the island.
That's unfortunate. She should be focusing on herself. Her new life. She shouldn't have to bear the burden of the outside world.
Okay.
Please. This is a matter best left to me and my advisors. We aren't planning to destroy the island. Those projections were merely to help us realize the cost of inaction.
Just a handy reference, huh? Expect us to just take your word on it?
If this thing involves the whole island, then you need help. I can be your problem solver if you let me in.
I suppose there's something to be said about refusing help, even when it's offered and you're in need. There's a conflict that's been brewing on this island shortly after we built Acadia. Between Far Harbor and the Children of Atom.
Oh, simply put, they want to kill each other, and each side wants us to help them.
We've tried to stay neutral, but Far Harbor was going to be wiped out by the fog, so that's when we built the condensers for them.
And I was friends with the previous leader of the Children of Atom, Confessor Martin. I even gave them their headquarters. The submarine base they named the Nucleus.
Which was a mistake, because Martin is gone and the new confessor, Tectus, is completely insane.
He's been threatening us, to force us to choose a side. I left behind something very important in that submarine base I gave them.
Dima's earliest memories are stored in the military computer banks in that base. Pre-war security systems and Confessor Martin's goodwill were supposed to keep them safe.
But now Tectus is in charge, and he's after Dima's memories. We don't even know what's in them.
But we do know that I spent nearly a century on this island alone. Whatever's in there is too dangerous to allow Tectus to get his hands on them.
Okay.
So what can I do to help?
If you're willing to retrieve what I've lost and bring my memories back to me, then we'd all be one step closer to solving this conflict without bloodshed.
You'll have to get through the Children of Atom's base. You're new on the island, so you might be able to pose as a recruit.
Then, once you get to the memory banks, you'll have to use a special program Dima and I have been working on to break through the security systems.
It's not going to be like a normal hack. You'll be breaking through a version of my own mental network. It'll consider you to be an intruder. I've loaded the program with some instructions I've recorded that will help guide you through it. I'm afraid it's difficult to explain without seeing it for yourself.
I'll get your memories, Dima.
If we're lucky, the pre-war defenses have kept the Children of Atom at bay. But that means you'll have to get past them yourself. One more thing before you leave. Whatever you do, don't assault the Children of Atom directly. Our ultimate goal must be to bring peace. If you attack them, they'll consider themselves at war with the outside world.
If we find anything suspicious in those memories of yours, we'll be back. Count on it.
Well, time to talk to Kasumi and see what she has to say about all this.
Turns out Dima's earliest memories are in the hands of the children of Adam. He's afraid of what they're going to find.
So, is that what those death projections were about? It wasn't Dima planning to destroy the island. He's worried the children of Adam will. Or is he still hiding something? What could be in those memories that he would leave them behind? Is there really something in them that's dangerous?
Possibly.
Into his memories? Assuming you can get past the children of Adam, of course.
I got this program that Faraday and Dima wrote. It's supposed to help me access the memory banks.
Really? How would that work? When I was taking a peek in the computers he has here, Dima was hooked up to his chair. I was just tapping into it. I wonder if you'll need to, you know, connect to the old banks the way he does? Some kind of connection between your head and the computer. Oh, but that's it. And then Faraday's program would be translating Dima's thoughts and data, helping you through any security guarding it. I'm sorry, I'm making assumptions. It's just, well, it's a little exciting, isn't it? You'll let me know what you find? I'll keep an eye on things here.
I'll get Dima's memories, and then we'll figure things out from there.
Good luck.
And we level up. What is this next level? We might need this if we're going in here. If we're gonna be running around in here, we're going to need rad resistance. I think 20 should be enough for now, but that won't.
Too many folks these days count on violence to solve their problems. We only have to look around to see where that got us.
Hey.
Go ahead. Any chance you got a second now?
Of course, Nick. What's up?
I wouldn't normally bother you with this sort of thing, but, well, I know I can trust you at this point. For as long as I can remember, I've been getting these, flashes, memories of places I've never been.
All right.
Things I've never seen. Memories of Nick's. They're not bad. They're just
distracting.
They're just this inescapable reminder that I'm not the person I think I am. That I'm not a person at all. I'm just a machine, pretending to be human.
You think. You feel. You're more than pretending, Nick.
Yeah, nice of you to say, but your kind don't usually have to deal with someone else's whole life trapped inside their skulls. Don't get me wrong. I know I'm in Nick's debt. These memories, they've kept me alive. Nick was a hell of a cop. A guy with good instincts and a good heart. I always counted myself lucky they didn't load me up with some ex-con. Or whatever type might volunteer to let folks tinker with their gray matter. But it's thanks to Nick that I pass for human. Why I get to live cushy in Diamond City, and every other synth is shot on sight. I know I got it good, but my entire life I owe to Nick. Everything that makes me who I am, my judgment, my speech, hell, even my name, they're his. And I can't do a damn thing about it, because without them, I'm nothing. A shell. All I want is a life where I have something I can call my own.
You've already built a life for yourself, Nick. You've got the agency, a home, friends.
Yeah, I mean, you're not wrong. You know, I'm just gonna need some time to think on this. I appreciate you hearing me out. You're a real good friend. Thanks.
All right, you're welcome.
You know, there is this chunk of Nick Valentine history I've been hoping to put a bow on for a while now. I could use a hand if you're willing to take a crack at it.
Oh, we're finally doing the thing.
Sure thing. What's the case?
Well, this one's straight out of the archives. Once upon a time, in the land of Boston, there lived a king of organized crime, Eddie Winter. He was a bad man. He did a lot of bad things, hurt a lot of innocent people. But he knew the end was coming, so he sealed himself inside a personal shelter, located underneath the sub shop he used as a headquarters.
Eddie Winter was from my time. Real scumbag.
The story gets even more twisted. The arrogant bastard wanted to cheat death, live forever, so he could come out of that shelter someday into this brave new world. Sound familiar? Only Eddie didn't want to be a frozen banana. No cryo sleep for him, no. He invested his money in some sick, crazy radiation experiment.
Nick, you can't be saying what I think you're saying.
Oh, I'm saying it all right. Eddie Winter went and turned himself into a ghoul 200 years before it was fashionable. Hell, he was probably the first one. And I'm convinced that he's still locked inside that shelter. Safe and sound. Ready to come out and begin his evil reign all over again. I'm gonna find him and kill him, so that never happens. You in?
All right, Nick. Let's get the bad guy.
You're a good man. Now, I know where Winter's vault is, but the door is sealed with a complex numerical code. Lucky for us, Winter's arrogance knew no bounds. Back in the day, he recorded 10 holotapes, incriminating different criminal associates. On each one, he hit a single number. We find all of those holotapes, we get all the numbers. We get all the numbers, we get the code. And then we get Winter. I've been putting together a file on this one for a while now. There's a pair of holotapes in here worth listening to. Including one of Winter's, I managed to snatch from the Cambridge police evidence lockup before getting swarmed by ferals. On my way out the door, I spotted an active evidence terminal. I bet my hat that terminal is the key to finding the rest of the tapes. Probably worth revisiting any police departments you may have stumbled across in your travels as well.
All right, well, let's see what we got. Case, Eddie Winter's self-inflicted ghoul, criminal kingpin, age 200 plus, offenses too many to count, location underground bunker, Andrew Station, sealed with a 10-digit code, holotapes hold the key to Winter's bunker, each tape is one piece of the entry code, 10 tapes total, 9 left, Cambridge Police Evidence Terminal, best lead for finding other tapes, possible remaining holotape locations, Commonwealth Police Department, Daffodil HQ. Alright, let's see what you got.
Message to Johnny Montrano. Johnny. You fat, lazy piece of shit.
I knew
this arrangement was too good to be true. Let's join forces with the North End, huh? Bury the hatchet? Work mutually against a common enemy? Well, you put the nail in that coffin, huh, boyo? What did you have to do, Johnny? Huh? What was your job? Sit in your car, on the corner. Keep your eyes open. If you see a uniform, you get out. Walk down the street, knock on the door, and let the fellas know there's trouble coming. Easy as pie, right? I could have got a 9-year-old from the projects to do it, but no. In the interest of Irish-Italian relations, I give the job to you. So what happens? Nothing. Nothing happens. You sit on your fat ass dribbling cannoli cream onto your third chin. You watch. You watch the uniform blow months of planning. All in 2 minutes. Congratulations, Johnny. You got me. You and your pal sure put the screws to old Eddie Winter. You should tell this funny story to your little girl when you tuck her in at night. In that corner bedroom upstairs. Pink wallpaper. Little house on Prince Street. Eddie Winter, signing off.
Detective Valentine. Captain Widmark, yeah. I'd just like to reiterate how excited we here at the Boston Police Department are that you'll be joining our investigation. Commissioner Turner has already regaled me with the tales of your adventures in Chicago. As you know, Edward L. Eddie Winter has been a pox on this beautiful city for nearly 2 decades.
Huh.
Extortion, murder, racketeering, kidnapping, name a crime he's committed. The epitome of a cold-blooded, brilliant, slippery crime boss. Fortunately for us, over the years, Winter has also developed that most self-destructive of character traits, supreme arrogance. Starting a little over a year ago, Winter stopped coding his correspondences and began communicating entirely via unencrypted holotape. Each one addressed the subject in question and very clearly signed off by Winter himself. He's obviously mocking the authorities. He knows we're monitoring his communications. He doesn't care. Winter thinks he's untouchable. He's wrong. This is when the game changes. Those holotapes are the key to building a case against Eddie Winter. And they're what this task force will focus on.
Huh.
His crimes, his words. Total self-incrimination. Get those holotapes, and we get Winter.
All right. Well, that was interesting. So yeah, I didn't hear a number. Did you guys hear a number? I think it was 3, I want to say. Because he said knock on the door 3 times. But yeah, we found Acadia, I think. We did a thing. Well, there's the nucleus. It's gonna be a bit of a hike to get over there, so I don't think we're gonna be doing that now. But I think we will go back to Far Harbor and talk to Captain Avery, and that I think that'll be the last thing we do. But yeah, it's a bit of a hike over to the nucleus, so we're not going to be doing that in this episode. Because I'm all out of time, almost. But I think what I do want to do is go check in with Captain Avery, see what she wants, talk to her, and also maybe do the little side quest with the guy with the synth.
Detective I've heard about.
I guess you could say that.
Oh, wonderful. I wasn't sure how I was ever going to find you.
Sounds like we may have another case on our hands.
Oh, dear.
I haven't been able to find any of the local police force, the louts. I don't want to start a panic, but, well, we may have a murder on our hands, and we need an outside set of eyes.
Where did the crime take place?
At the Cliff's Edge Hotel, just north of the town. Please, you must help us. Every moment we wait, our residents are at risk.
Who's the victim?
Well, we want to keep this out of the tabloids, but it's Ezra Parker, the financier of the hotel. Will you help us solve this heinous crime?
Who are your employers?
I'm not at liberty to give out my employer's personal information, but all right. You will, of course, be meeting with them if you take the case. Will you help us? There may still be a murderer at large.
Okay, I'll help.
Oh, thank goodness. Shall I guide you to the Cliff's Edge Hotel now?
Where is it again?
The Cliff's Edge Hotel, just up the coast from town. You really can't miss it. Shall we be off?
Go ahead. I'll meet you there.
Very good. I shall meet you at the main entrance to the hotel.
Need general supplies? Visit the bait shop.
What am I looking for?
You need it?
Data. Let's just collect this.
Jeff's got it.
Guns.
If you got caps, I got goods.
I need to talk to you about a missing synth.
Yeah? Well, it's not something I talk about with outsiders. So you can either buy something or move along.
I'm working with Chase. She told me that your designation is L792.
Okay, I believe you. Keep it down, all right? It's real private information. I know the synth you're talking about. He's a younger guy. Maybe early 20s with white hair. Goes by the name Derek. Thing is, he showed up way earlier than he was supposed to. Thought a courser was on his tail, so he rushed the timetable. To be honest, the guy was a wreck. He was scared shitless. Looking over his shoulder every 5 minutes and attracting unwanted attention. Tried to calm him down, but he panicked and ran off into the fog. That was the last I saw of him.
All right.
Relax. I'll take care of this.
Sorry. My nerves are a little shot right now.
That's fine.
If you're really going after that synth, I'm pretty sure he took the road south out of town.
All right.
You could head that way. Just be careful out there. And thanks. There aren't many who'd go out in the fog to help a synth, especially one they don't even know. I feel like shit about what happened. I really do. I hope you can make it right.
All right, we talked to Brooks.
A mainlander like you stands no chance against the crawlers.
Where's Captain Avery, though? Captain Avery, you up there? There you are.
Avery.
I'll be straight with you. It's never easy to ask anyone on this island for help.
Okay.
Much less a stranger. But I've got a responsibility to these people, and I have a job for you, if you're up for it. Besides, I know you're tougher than you look.
I'm happy to help with anything I can.
If you say so. We get our drinking water from a purifier not far outside of town.
All right.
We had a bad storm not long before you got here, and it must have damaged the fog condensers that protect the road to the purifier. I sent Howard Dunbar out to fix them. He was out there when the Mirelurks hit us, and I'm afraid they might have got him, too. I was hoping you might go have a look. If the worst happened, maybe you could get those fog condensers back online. If you're up to it, just head south out of town. It's paying work, of course. I wouldn't ask a stranger to stick their neck out on our behalf, unless I was willing to pay a fair share for it.
Am I gonna need any tools or parts if I have to make these repairs on my own?
The fog condensers need their power modules replaced, but Howard took the only spares we had. Either way, you're gonna have to find him first.
All right, I'll head out there now.
Good.
All right.
Our water supply won't last much longer.
All right, well, either way, I think I am going to leave it here. All right, well, we've done a major chunk of this, so I think I'm going to leave it here. So, yeah, thank you guys so much for watching this episode. If you liked it, hit that like and the subscribe button. Also, be sure to follow me on Facebook and on Twitter in the description below.